Hello, everyone, and welcome to another episode of 3Max. Today, I'll be going over eglot, a powerful LSP client for Emacs. I'm really excited to share this video with you because it's going to help you set up a more advanced feature of Emacs, and I'll aim to keep it simple and approachable. We'll focus on setting up eglot and some of the basic commands and configurations. If you're enjoying the content, don't forget to like, subscribe, and leave a comment. I really appreciate your feedback. Before we start to understand eglot, let's first go over the concept of a language server. Language servers provide information about code to client editors such as Emacs, Vim, VS Code, and other IDEs. Language servers provide information such as where functions and variables are defined, the type signatures of functions, and much more. Initially, this kind of logic was built directly into the IDEs, but now that the number of languages and IDEs has grown, these systems have been decoupled into a server-client model. Thus, each language server only needs to understand its own language, and each client can focus on the task of displaying the relevant information to the user. So for this video, I'll get eglot working with Golang. However, this process should be mostly the same, no matter which language you choose. So the first step is to install our language server. I'm on Windows, and for Golang, all I need to do is run this go install command. Now that I've got the Golang language server set up, it should be as simple as running metax eglot to start eglot. The first command I'd like to show is xref find definitions. So what this does is when we've highlighted a symbol, like a function or a variable name, and we press meta dot or meta period, it runs xref find definitions and takes us to the definition of that symbol. So for the function, it takes me here to the definition of basic function call. And to go back to where I was, I can just press meta comma. This also works for variables, as you'll see here with this variable. I press meta dot and it takes me to the definition. And again, I can press meta comma to go back. The next helpful command I'm going to show is xref find references, which is typically bound to meta question mark. So once we're highlighting a function, we go ahead and press meta question mark, and it'll show us multiple references to that function. For example, here's the definition of the function on line 11, and here are two function calls on line 25 and 31. And we can go to any of these function calls by hitting enter, and you see that it'll take me there up top. And we can go back to this little buffer here and hit Q to exit. Another very helpful feature of eglot is the symbol completion feature. So whether that's function calls or variables, we can start typing, for example, this is, and run command meta I, and it'll start to complete. So it completed to this is, because there are two completions there. And if I press it again, it'll show me the possible completions. So I can type either A or N to begin completing as needed, and then run again command meta I to complete the rest of the variable name. And let's see if this works for functions as well. So again, command meta I, and look at that. There it is. Renaming functions is a very common use case, and it's great that eglot has us covered here. So all we need to do is run metax eglot rename, and it'll ask us for the new function name. So let's rename basic function call to super function call. And so all we have to do is type in the new name and hit enter, and you'll notice that all of the references to basic function call have been updated to super function call. Lastly, another great feature of eglot is that it integrates the LSP with Emacs's FlyMake, which is a syntax checking mode. So if we update this variable name to something incorrect, you see that it quickly highlights it to underline it in red, and we can mouse over to see this information coming from the LSP, which is that the compiler has found that there's an undeclared name. This is not A. We need to complete it, and we can complete it again with command meta I. Okay, that was just a brief tour of eglot, a powerful addition to Emacs that enables integration with many different language servers to provide contextual information about variables and functions, as well as completion and navigation commands. If you have any questions, don't forget to leave a comment. Also, I'm still learning eglot, so if I've missed anything or made any mistakes, let me know. As always, thanks for watching.